y'all. Welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I wanted to come quickly and just talk to you briefly about whether or not fibroids grow back if you choose to get the myomectomy surgery. And the answer is yes and no. Some women get a myomectomy surgery and they never have another issue with fibroids. But there are some people, and I think there's quite a few, who get myomectomies and a couple years later they have the same issues that they started with when they originally had fibroids. So the reason for this video is, if you decide that you're going to get myomectomy surgery, I would still encourage you to change your lifestyle, because changing your lifestyle can be the difference between fibroids growing back or not. Because when we have an estrogenic dominant lifestyle, fibroids tend to grow. And what that means is you're eating a lot of meat and dairy and your diet is just way off the charts. As far as estrogen is concerned, you may think you eat a healthy diet, but your diet might be high in estrogen-rich foods. And also, you might be using cleaning products, hair products, things of that nature that cause fibroids to grow. And there's a lot of different factors that cause fibroids to grow: stress, just lifestyle issues, and I'm not going to go into all of that right now in this video, but I just want to encourage you to watch my videos, and I share with you lots of information about how to keep fibroids away, how to shrink fibroids, how to live an estrogen-free lifestyle. So I just wanted to share that with you, because some women, you know, have large fibroids and they're still able to get myomectomy surgeries. I don't know how they're able to do that with some people when they have large fibroids. I wasn't a candidate for that. I think it was because of where my fibroids were located, and I don't even like to say my fibroids because I don't claim fibroids, but I wasn't a candidate for that. The only option I had was to get a complete hysterectomy. I think they wanted to leave one ovary. That was what they had said was the best option for me, and that wasn't the road that I wanted to go, so I didn't get any of those things done. But I don't know what things they look for to tell if you're a candidate for myomectomy surgery or not, but this video is not about that. It's about just encouraging you to think about some lifestyle changes so that fibroids don't grow back. And that's it. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much, and I'll talk to you soon. Take care.